Hello and welcome to another episode of my Beginner's Guide to Using Todoist. My name is Carl Pullin and this episode is all about using Todoist on your mobile device. Now, over the course of this mini-series, I've covered pretty much everything from creating tasks to getting tasks into your inbox, labels, filters, and notes, as well as settings. Now, what I'm going to show you today is the mobile app. Now, the mobile app is pretty much the same as the desktop app. And as I mentioned in the earliest episodes, that you do, if you're doing your planning and you're doing your setting up, you want to be doing that on the desktop version. It just gives you much more screen real estate to drag and drop things around and just to get it fine-tuned to the way that you want to use it. And then using your mobile device as the quick go-to, the quick entry. You know, when you're running around and you get, oh, I must remember to do that. Bang, you get it into your mobile device. You may want to refer to your mobile device to see, okay, what do I need to do next? So that's where the mobile device is at its strongest. You can do planning in your mobile device, on your mobile device, but it's a lot more difficult than doing it on a desktop device. The desktop just gives you that much more real estate. So before we go any further though, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo account now, and I will show you how to use Todoist on your mobile device. Okay, so we're now moving on to the mobile device. Now, I have exactly the same account as I've been showing you in previous episodes on the desktop. And so what I wanted to do is now show you what it looks like when you transfer to the mobile device. So what we've got here is, this is kind of the home screen. So when you open up Todoist, this is what you're going to see. So we've got your projects here, which will open. And as you can see, we've got the same projects that you had before. So your home, your work, your someday. We've got our labels, exactly the same labels as we had on the desktop. And we've got the filters that we created in the last episode. So if I wanted to now see my today's priorities, tap that, and that's going to show me my today's priorities. So that's all there, and I can go into my today view right here. So those are some of the things. They're just the same. Now, what I really wanted to do was to show you essentially how you can quickly add a task. So when you come into Todoist, you're going to come from this. So let's just close that up. So let's say you come in from this window. You can just hit the plus button at the bottom, and that's going to bring up your quick entry. Now, the quick entry is really simple. So we'll go, this is, and as usual, I'm, oh dear, this is a new task. Okay, so what we've got is we've got the actual substance of the task right there. And what Todoist have done is they've made it as really simple as they possibly can. So what we can do now is you can tap on where it says no date. Tap that, I can hit today, and that's going to give me today. I can hit the where it says inbox, and I can assign it to my, say, home. And then what we can do now, what I want to show you there is look at what's happened in the task line there. It's got the hashtag home. So let's say now I want to add a label. Now I have a couple of ways of doing that. I can hit the label down there at the bottom left hand corner. I can hit the flag, I can add a time, and I can add a comment. But what I want to do is show you a quick way. I can just hit at, and that's now going to the at sign. So that's the ampersand. I've forgotten what we actually call that. The at sign. In Korean, we call it the golbaengi, but the at sign. And now I have all my labels here. So this is a new task. Let's give that chores. I can spell it right now. And so that just adds the chores. When I'm done, all I need to do is, by the way, I can also type P. One, and that's now going to give it a flag of P1. So you can do typing. You don't actually have to use the icons. And by the way, that works exactly the same in the desktop. I forgot to show you that when we were doing labels in episode, I think it was 5 or 6. But anyway, that's something I forgot to show you. You can just use these symbols, these
these kind of quick shortcuts, which is the hashtag for a project and the @ for a label. Once I'm done, all I have to do is hit this red arrow at the bottom. So hit that, and that's now been added. You can tap anywhere on the screen and that will come up. So what we've done is I put that one, if I remember correctly, I put that one in my home project. So let's just go in there. So this is a new task, it's there. If I tap on that, I can edit it. You can drag it up and you can get all the various details. It's almost exactly the same window that you have on the desktop, which is one of the reasons why I wanted to show you it on the desktop first. You can drag that back down like that, and it's all done. So that's one way that you can do with your mobile devices. Now, one of the things that a lot of people like to do with mobile devices is set up a start screen. So if to do that, you just go into your settings, which is the top right there, go into general, and you've got here an option for start page. Now, a lot of these, like labels and filters, of course, they are part of the premium version. But if we just close the labels and I'll close the filters, you can ignore those. If you're using the actual, if you're using the free version and only want to use the free version, well, you can decide where you want to start it. So you can start it from your inbox if you wish, or you can start it from upcoming. You can start it from home or your work project, wherever you want to start. So let's say I want to start this from my home project. I click that. I come out of settings. I'm done. Now, if I go out of Todoist and then click Todoist again, actually, let's what I have to do is I've got to remove Todoist, open it up, and now you'll see that it's opened up in my home view. So you can change that as much as you like. I can go back to this screen here. I can change that. Now, one of the most common ones is when we go back into today, start page would be, I would start it on today because you want to have a quick list. But if you have a lot of tasks in your today view and you are using the premium version, the one that I'd prefer to start with is use one of my filters. So I would probably start with something like today's priorities and that would be done. So that's where I would like to start because I want to see the things that when I open up Todoist on my phone, I want to see the tasks that I'm actually doing. Now, just a few quick tips. If you open up, if you create a task and hit the plus button at the bottom here, I can just tap that and I can drag that plus button wherever I want. So I can drag it in there and I can add tasks in there. Now notice I'm in the today view. So when I did that now and I let go, it creates the quick entry and you'll notice that it's been given the date today. So let's just come out of that. I don't want to add that one. Let's go into a project and do the same thing. Let's tap the plus and drag it up to there. And you'll notice that it's actually come in the work project. If you want something to go into your to-do list, if you want to go into the inbox, either you create the task from here. So if I just tap here, you'll see that it comes into inbox, or you just start it from your inbox itself. So that's just a quick tip, because one thing that I found very frustrating was if I'm starting in today view, that means that immediately this task is going to be dated today, but it will go into my inbox and I don't want to date it today. I can tap on that and change that very quickly to no date. So it's not actually that difficult, but it's something to keep in mind when you're using your mobile device. So pretty much everything that I've shown you on the desktop is exactly the same as you get on your mobile device. You know, it's Todoist have spent a lot of time since last year unifying all their apps so they all work in the same way, so you're not having to learn different ways. And this is just a really, really simple way of just creating that thing. Now, one thing I wanted to show you was, let's say I wanted to add one thing I didn't show in the filters video in the previous episode, was let's just go into my today's priorities. You'll see up at the top there I've got three dots. If I tap there, I can edit the filter and I can select the task. So you can just go in there, you can edit the filters. Now, when I go into edit the filter, let's say I'm going to give that, it's working in here, give it the color red because it's my priorities. I can also add this to my favorites. So tap on my favorites, I'm done. Go out of there and now you'll see that my today's priority has come under my label for my wife, which is RK. So that's another way that you can actually quickly, so when you come to your this is what I think filters have been designed for, not so much the desktop, more for the mobile. So I can just tap on that and it will give me my priorities for today. And it's really, really fast. So when you combine your planning sessions on your desktop, which I always would recommend, is do your planning sessions on your desktop because you get a much bigger view. And your mobile phone is for the everyday on the go, quickly grabbing tasks, quickly viewing to see what you need to do next. So you can set it up that way, which is what I've done with these priorities in my real account. I do have my today's priorities at the very top, and I also have a filter I call my today's focus, which is similar basically to today's priorities. It's all the ones that I flagged for today. So there you go. That's a quick overview of using your mobile phone. It's a fantastic tool on your phone. It's incredibly fast and incredibly reliable, and it's something that I wish you just to get used to using, because you'll find that it becomes an invaluable tool for you to grab your tasks as and when you need to do them and to see what you need to do next. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system, that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.